Hi guys, happy holidays! In this video, we'll take a closer look at the new accessory type ancient equipment coming in the next episode patch update of Ragnarok Mobile Eternal Love. We'll highlight the total stats you can get at plus 15 refinement and the notable random attribute that you can get for each gear. We'll also do a comparison of the ancient equipment versus the old equipment, if applicable. Hopefully this will help you determine which ones are the most suitable for your character. Alright, without further ado, let's begin. Let's start with the ancient accessories for physical damage dealers. First, we have the black gold pendant, which is suitable for melee job classes. It grants plus 12 strength, plus 9% melee attack, and a chance to get 1.5% to 4.5% physical damage. When comparing it with Ring of Contract, this ancient gear provides 3% less physical attack, but 4.5% more melee damage. Thus, it's better than Ring of Contract if you get the ideal random attribute. On the other hand, if you compare Black Gold Pendant with Hermit's Bundle, you'll have 4% more melee attack and 0.5% more melee damage, but lose extra damage dealt to Formless and Angel Race, as well as a side effect with Ninja Clothes' Cold Night Song, which grants 10% crit damage and 1000 max HP. So I think Hermit's Bundle will still be somewhat useful when fighting against these two races. Second, we have the Golden Harp, which is suitable for ranged job classes. It grants plus 12 dex, plus 9% range attack, and a chance to get 1.5% to 4.5% physical damage. In comparison with Dog Servant, Golden Harp has an edge since it gives 3% more range attack and 0.5% more range damage if you get the perfect random attribute. However, you'll lose the 5% extra damage dealt to Demon and Brute race, so Dog Servant will still be somewhat better when fighting against these two races. On the other hand, if you compare Golden Harp with Gunslinger's Hunting Certificate, you'll get 6% higher range attack and 1.5% more range damage, but lose 2% Ignore Death, 10% Demi-Human damage reduction from the side effect with Ranger Boots, and a chance to inflict darkness to enemies when attacking. So in PvP, Gunslinger's Hunting Certificate might still be more helpful for utility and survivability. Third, we have Crystal of Nihility for boosting Ignore Defense. It grants plus 8 Strength, plus 8 Dex, plus 9% Ignore Death, and a chance to get 1.5% to 4.5% physical damage. Most physical skill builds aim for 200% Ignore Death for clearing the Legend difficulty of Thanatos Tower and Museum Island. Thus, this ancient gear will be suitable if you still lack Ignore Death to reach 200%. Next, for Auto Attack or AA builds, there are several options available and you can choose depending on which stat you're lacking. First is Gold Earrings for boosting crit rate. It grants plus 384 raw attack, plus 20 crit rate, and a chance to get 1.5% to 4.5% physical penetration. If you compare it with Fisher Beam, you'll have 20 more raw attack, but lose 4% attack. Despite the lower percent attack, I still think Gold Earrings is better overall since penetration is more significant against enemies with huge damage reduction stat. Next, we have the Love Brooch for boosting crit damage. It increases luck by 16 and crit damage by up to 24%. Love Brooch will certainly be better than Lucky Star if you roll the mid or max value for the crit damage random attribute. Next, we have the Heritage Greystone for boosting agi and attack speed. There's also a chance to get 1.5% to 4.5% physical penetration. When comparing it with Seventh Sense, the ancient gear grants 6% lower attack speed, but 4.5% higher pen. So if you can already reach the max 480% attack speed even without the extra 6% from 7th Sense, then the Heritage Greystone will definitely be superior in terms of DPS. Lastly, we have the Ocean Silver Coin for boosting AA attack and AA damage. It grants plus 12 strength, plus 180 AA attack, and a chance to get plus 1.5% to 4.5% AA damage. If you compare it with Ninja's Advanced Guide, the ancient gear grants extra 100 AA attack, but 1.5% lower AA damage and no movement speed. So for Flowing Blade Ninjas, you might need to test first whether you need more AA attack or AA damage before deciding to switch. The other random attributes that you can get for these ancient accessories are more on the defensive side, and they are as follows. Notably for purple quality ancient accessories, the second line random attribute will grant increased damage to players in PvP and GBG. Next, let's take a look at the ancient accessories from magic damage dealers. First, we have the flower hairpin for a significant boost in percent magic attack. It grants plus 8 int, plus 8 dex, and up to 30% magic attack if you get the ideal random attribute. When comparing it with Tibber's Hand and Kraken's Eye, this ancient gear provides 10% more magic attack, but zero ignore MDef. Thus, it's only better to shift to Flower Hairpin if you've already reached your target ignore MDef, despite not getting the ignore MDef from Tibber's Hand or Kraken's Eye. Furthermore, I think Flower Hairpin will be more beneficial to physical classes that utilize magic attacks such as Rune Masters, Begetters, and even rifle-build Gunslingers. Next, we have the Ring of Light and Shadow, which boosts both percent magic attack and ignore MDef. It grants plus 8 int, plus 8 dex, plus 15% ignore MDef, and a chance to get 5% to 15% magic attack. When comparing it with Tibber's Hand and Kraken's Eye, this ancient gear provides higher ignore MDef, but slightly lower percent magic attack. Ideally, magic DPS builds should have 200% ignore MDef for clearing the legend difficulty of Thanatos Tower and Museum Island. Thus, it will be better to use the Ring of Light and Shadow if you still lack ignore MDef to reach 200%. Next, we have Lady's Gloves for boosting raw magic attack and MPen and reducing variable cast time. It grants 320 raw magic attack, plus 8 int, plus 8 dex, and 30% variable cast time reduction, which are useful for new players who still have low int and dex stats. There's also a chance to get 3% to 9% magic penetration. In comparison with Tibber's Redemption, you'll lose a lot of stats if you switch to this ancient gear, such as 80 raw magic attack, 4 dex, and 8% magic attack. However, I think it can still be compensated by the possibility of having the max value for MPen, which is more difficult to grow. Next, we have the Conductor's Brooch for boosting ignore MDef, MPen, and attack speed. It grants plus 8 int, plus 8 dex, plus 10% ignore MDef, plus 10% attack speed, and a chance to get 3% to 9% MPen. If you still lack ignore MDef to reach 200%, then this will be better than Lady's Gloves. When compared to Time Manipulator, the Conductor's Brooch grants 5% more ignore MDef, 5% higher attack speed, and 1% higher MPen if you get the perfect random attribute. The disadvantage though is that you'll have 5% lower magic attack if you switch to this ancient gear. Next, we have the Scorching Essence for boosting fire element damage. It grants plus 8 int, plus 8 strength, and up to 24% fire element damage. In comparison with Flame Feather, you'll gain 8 more strength and 4% fire element damage if you get the ideal random attribute. However, you lose 4 int and 10% variable cast time reduction. In addition, ninjas and Ronin warriors will lose the set effect of their weapon and flame feather if replaced with the ancient gear. So I guess Scorching Essence will be more useful for Rune Masters, Begetters, and Slayers. And lastly, we have the Fluorite button for boosting water element damage. It grants plus 8 int, plus 8 strength, and up to 24% water element damage. It has an edge over Water Drop Brooch since it gives more magic attack, int, and strength, as well as 10% more water damage if you get the perfect random attribute. The only stats you'll lose are 108 attack and minus 5% water damage taken. The other random attributes that you can get from these ancient accessories are more on the defensive side, and they are as follows. Notably for purple quality ancient accessories, the second line random attribute will grant increased damage to players in PvP and GBG. Lastly, let's take a look at the ancient accessories for tanks and supports. First, we have the Vow Necklace for boosting max HP. It grants plus 12 vit and 8% max HP. The best random attribute that you can get is either 2% to 6% max HP or 2% to 6% demi-human damage reduction. If you compare it with the Ring of Immortality, Vow Necklace will be clearly better as you'll have 2% more max HP if you get the max value. On the other hand, if you compare it with Survival Ring, you'll get extra 8 vit and 4% more max HP, but lose 5% demi-human damage reduction if you get the max value for HP. But if you get the max value for demi-human damage reduction, you'll have extra 8 vit, and 1% more reduction but 2% less max HP. Another point of consideration when comparing these two accessories is that Survival Ring boosts HP for every enhancement and refinement level. A plus 15 Survival Ring with 170 enhancement will provide 4,700 HP. And lastly, we have the Blessing Bracelet for boosting max SP. It grants plus 8 int, plus 8 strength, plus 600 max SP, and a chance to get 4% to 12% max SP. When comparing it with other accessories that increase SP such as Ring of Loyalty, Bright Moon, and Morpheus Ring, the Ancient Gear clearly provides higher max SP. However, the Asura Strike and Hellgate damage modifiers from Ring of Loyalty and the SP regen and trap damage from Bright Moon should also be considered. If you just intend to increase max SP, such as for improving the damage of Stellar Hunter's Star Arrows, then Blessing Bracelet is possibly the best option. The other random attribute that you can get for these ancient accessories are as follows. Alright, so far I've gone through the stats of the new ancient accessories coming in the next episode update. Do take note that the exact names may be translated differently once the patch is released in the English servers. Which ancient gears are you looking forward to? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Alright, that's it for this video guys. Don't forget to like if you enjoyed watching this guide. If you're new here, I would love for you to consider subscribing by hitting the subscribe button down below. I would love to have you back. Thank you for watching and see you in our next episode.